Dear spoken English learners, hope you are well. Today, we will start our spoken English with the ground of outside home. Outside home at road and clinic. Okay? And this day, we will dedicate our spoken English class to doctors, patients, police and journalists. To those who are sacrificing themselves in this quarantine period for the common people. Okay, salute to doctors, police and journalists. So let's start to in our spoken English class. First time we will learn some important words. Regularly we are doing this. Learners, you keep ready for your spoken English class with the vocabulary. So notice the vocabulary first. Next we will go to our dialogue program. Have you taken your pen and paper, dear learners? Though it is spoken English, but to have the records and procedures, you need pen and paper. I always tell it. Okay, the first word, today's first word is nutritious. Everybody, and you will notice that I write down the words which are adjacent to our daily lives and also to our daily learning classes in spoken English. Here I have noted five words today after another five words of last day. Nutritious, number one, not only meaning but also for pronunciation, I have noted this words regularly. First, pronounce with me, dear learner. Nutritious, nutritious. Okay, here nutri, nutri. There is accent upon R and I, R and I. And shas, nutritious. Here the accent is on R and I, but the accent is in lower sense, in upon OU. O-U-S, it's in lower sense, upon O-U-S. Upper sense accent is on T-R-I, T-R-I, tree, nutritious, nutritious, pushtikar. Health, number two, health, the accent is on E and A, health, shastho, we know everybody this word, health. Substance, number three, substance. Okay, here substance, two accent on U, here sub and stance on A, substance. It means upadan, substance. We need our nutritious substances in our body to maintain our health and to protect the viruses, especially present virus, coronavirus. We must have our nutritious elements or substance in our body. So I have noted these words today. And very much common word today, stay. We always hear of this word nowadays, stay home, stay safe. So stay means abusthan kara, stay. The pronunciation will be stay. Okay. And also growth, growth, the accent will be on O and W, growth, growth, vriddhi or ba janmo, growth. Okay learners, let's revise these five words today with our accent. Nutritious, pushtikar, health, shastho, substance, upada, stay, abusthan kara, growth, vriddhi, janmo. How do you feel to learn these words? I think you feel well. And it's the only example from me. You can also arrange more words. You can read English newspapers regularly. If it is not possible daily, but once a week, collect an English newspaper and read the news and collect unknown words from here every day or every week and learning. And now you have the
the facilities to have the pronunciation available from your smartphones. You can collect there from there its meaning and pronunciation also. Okay, so such way you increase your vocabulary so that you are able to speak in English regularly, fluently. Okay, fine. Let's come to our today's situation. Our today's situation is also quarantine period. Situation, if I say of situation, the situation is quarantine period. Situation, you write down please, because we need a written form during our learning period. Quarantine period, quarantine period. Okay, and today's ground is outside home at road and clinic, and the conversation will among doctor, patient, police and journalist. Okay, so we have these characters in our dialogue program for spoken English: doctor, patient, police and journalist. Okay, suppose a police is doing his duty on road and you patient, may God keep you out of disease. Just it's suppose you are patient here. The police is asking you, to where are you going? Where are you going? Please write down. Learners, please write down. During speaking, you will speak freely. Don't use any copy, but to learn about speaking, you must have these documents in written form. So please write down with me. Police is asking, where are you going? Then patient, he is in a transport and he is giving his answer, I'm sick. I am sick. And notice here, where? The pronunciation will be where are, but in spoken form you will have to pronounce where are you going. Patient, I'm sick. I am, but in spoken form it's I'm sick. So I'm going to IEDCR, you know, it's at Mohakhali and it's that corona test center just now, and it has various purposes in medical treatment, but just now it's very much known as our corona test place. So I'm sick, so I'm going to IEDCR to have test for coronavirus, coronavirus. Speak my son, you know, the patient cannot move alone, so he may go with his young son, adult son, and he is perhaps an aged person. This patient, usually the aged persons are attacked more by the coronavirus. All the persons of all ages are very much in risk with this virus, and all are being attacked of any age, but especially the child and the old people are in risk much. So patient is replying, I'm sick, so I'm going to IEDCR to have test for coronavirus with my son. Next, this police then tell him, oh I see, okay pass away. That is, he is indicating the driver to pass away the road. Now it's the place. So here at first it was the place at road. It was at road. But now outside of home you have already reached at IEDCR. So, now at the gate of IDCL. Now it's at the gate of IDCL. So, we may say at IDCL, here the patient is taking his position, and here the patient may ask to a duty officer. To a duty officer. See the duty doctor. May I see the duty doctor? আমি কি কর্তব্যরত চিকিৎসকের সাথে সাক্ষাৎ করতে পারি? মে আই সি দ্য ডিউটি ডক্টর? পেশেন্ট জিজ্ঞেস করছেন, জিজ্ঞেস করছেন যখন তখন ডিউটি অফিসার আছেন সেখানে, তিনি ডিউটি অফিসার, তিনি এরকম একটা আনসার দিতে পারেন, শিওর শিওর, কিন্তু দ্যাট ইজ এ প্রসিডিওর, বাট গো টু দ্য কিউ. Queue, you know, the process of queue is very much available throughout the world, especially in the foreign lands and nowadays in our country also. And in this coronavirus period, all are maintaining this queue everywhere. We get queue in the whole the year in railway station to have the tickets. Okay. We have queue in the shops also dealing payment. Okay, but nowadays we face queue everywhere to maintain a social distancing. So duty officer says, sure, but go to the queue. Having social distancing, যে আপনি সামাজিক দূরত্ব এখানে একটা লাইনে যান, ডিস্টেন্সিং। সো ডিউটি অফিসার ইজ টেলিং দ্য পেশেন্ট, শিওর বাট গো টু দ্য কিউ হ্যাভিং সোশ্যাল ডিস্টেন্সিং। তো অলরেডি দ্য পেশেন্ট হ্যাজ ফলোড হিজ অ্যাডভাইস অ্যান্ড নাও দ্য প্লেস ইজ অ্যাট ডক্টর্স চেম্বার। ইটস ডক্টর্স chamber. You know, without doctors meeting, there is no scope to have any test. So at doctor's chamber, the duty doctor is talking to the patient, and he is talking to him, what problem do you face? What problem do you face? What problem do you face? তুমি কি সমস্যা বোধ করছো? What problem do you face? And now patient is replying. Patient is replying, I feel feverish. আমার জ্বর জ্বর ভাব হচ্ছে। I feel feverish. And dear learner, there is a scope to explain this word feel. This is a conception word. And learn here, feel, see, notice, hope, such type of words doesn't take the ing form usually. I feel feverish. I'm a Georgia both. I feel. Okay. I feel feverish with cough and sneezing. I feel feverish with cough and sneezing. আমি জর্জর বোধ করছি, কাশি এবং সর্দি সহ। I feel feverish with cough and sneezing. Now what may the doctor say? Let's see what may the doctor say. Now doctor, after checking with stethoscope, first time doctor will check with stethoscope. So we may here write down, yes, it's current sentence. What do you face? Or how do you feel? What problem do you face? Yes, it's correct sentence. It's not facing. Face is also just like feel. So here, during conversation, the meaning is in continuous, but the throwing of English sentence here should be in simple present. So it's correct sentence. What problem do you face? I feel feverish, but it's all are in continuous sense, but in simple present form. It's a way in speaking English to talk to each other, okay? And also to use this conception word, feel, see, such types of word. And similarly, also face. Now, what problem do you face? Or how do you feel? These are correct sentences. So after checking with stethoscope, next the doctor may ask him, what may the doctor ask? The doctor may ask him, you need corona test. Just it's a making a story to have a dialogue portion. So and the process will not be exactly how a patient and doctor each other converse, and also what activities are taken among them, but just to have a scene, just to make a scene. No facing. It is how do you feel, how do you face, what problem do you face, not facing. Yeah, it's the spoken form, so we may use a simple present form. Doctor, you need coronavirus test. You need coronavirus test. Coronavirus test. I've already told you, dear learner, that the scene is just artificial scene here to make a conversation. Just we are learning conversation. So all the things will not be done as the story takes place at the doctor's chamber. Just we are making an artificial scene here. And you need, as you cannot say, you are needing, so you cannot tell, you are facing, or you are, how are you facing. No, it will not be very much appropriate to think and say and listen. You need coronavirus test here. And take this slip, the doctor is telling him. Take this slip, he is writing a slip, and then he is telling, take this slip and go to corona test counter, and go to corona test counter. Take this slip and go to corona test counter. Then a scene after test, after giving test, not the result. After giving test, not the result. After giving test, not the result. Here, whenever the patient already has given test, he has come out of the test counter, and then a journalist faces him. A journalist. He is asking him, how have you got cooperation here? How cooperation here have you got? How cooperation have you got here? Have you got or gotten? Both are correct. Have you got here? Got also past and past participle. Both. Gotten is past participle. Journalist, how cooperation have you got here? তুমি এখানে কেমন cooperation পেয়েছো? The patient is replying. The question is, I have got enough cooperation. I have. Not receive, not have. I have got enough cooperation. Ami jatishto cooperation pechi. I have got enough cooperation. Okay. Then the journalist also asks him, was the authority cordial to him or not? Okay, but there is a comment here also. But just now, journalist will ask him a question. Did you get? Did the authority, that is the IEDC authority, did the authority show, did the authority show their cordiality to you, did the authority show their cordiality to you? Okay, did the authority show their cordiality to you? In another language, the Burmese can also ask him such way, was the authority cordial to you? Was the authority cordial to you? Cordial to you? In any form, this question may be asked. And the present here replying in positive sense, yes, they were. Were also maybe in this short form, are or were. They were cordial, but they were cordial, but they are cordial children, they are uncle children, but there's a huge pressure. Dear learner, notice my pronunciation, pressure. The spelling is S-S-U-R-E, but the pronunciation is pressure. Okay, this R-E will be omitted. Yes, they were cordial, but there is a huge pressure of patience, huge pressure of a lot of patience here, There is a huge pressure of lot of patience here, Actually, they were cordial, but there is a huge pressure of lot of patience here on them. তাদের উপরে প্রচুর রোগীর চাপ রয়েছে, ঠিক আছে? তো পেশেন্ট অলরেডি ইজ স্যাটিসফাইড, বাট I am satisfied at their service, but I am satisfied with their service. I am satisfied with their service. S-E-R-V-I-C-E. Service. Here also, R will keep omitted. Service. Okay. Notice my pronunciation. Service. The accent will go on I. Patient is telling us. They were cordial, but there is a huge pressure of a lot of patience here. But I am satisfied with their service. The patient has already answered. Here the journalist. He is answering. Thank you for your opinion. Thank you for your opinion. Apnar motamoter jonno dhonnobad. The patient is said, You are welcome. Yes, you are welcome. Let's keep silent a few moments, dear learners. For the time being of Azan, please keep silent.
dear learners, let's revise our conversation today. I have already explained the accents with you and also the meaning and the situation and also tense, form of tense of everything during our conversation in spoken English. And now I will just read out the conversation plainly. You will notice my pronunciation and the situation, in which situation which speeches may come. Police at road. Where are you going? Patient. I'm sick. So I'm going to IE this year to have test for coronavirus with my son. Police. Oh, I see. Okay, pass away. At IE this year. Patient. May I see the duty doctor? Duty officer. Sure, but go to the queue, having social distancing. At doctor's chamber. Doctor. What problem do you face? Patient. I feel feverish with cough and sneezing. After checking with stethoscope, doctor says, you need coronavirus test. Take this sleeve and go to corona test counter. After giving test, journalist, how cooperation have you got here? Patient, I have got enough cooperation. Journalist, did the authority show their cordiality to you? Or in another form, was the authority cordial to you? Patient, yes, they are cordial. They were cordial, but there is a huge pressure of a lot of patients here on them. But I'm satisfied with their service. Journalist, oh yes, thank you for your opinion. Patient, you are welcome. So, okay, dear learner, see, the patient is also struggling. So I also have the salute also for the patients who are struggling in suffering against the coronavirus disease, COVID-19. So, okay, these were our today's conversation. And dear learners, you come to your live class in spoken English on both Sunday and Thursday at about 3 or 4 p.m. Usually on 3 p.m. Today it was late. And learn words with me, just like this, and just like last class. Every classes you will get new words, and though you may know the meaning of these words, but I like to converse with you with the pronunciation of the words and also with the dialogue in each class to be familiar in speaking English. Okay, goodbye everybody.